To pursue the computer analogy, I suppose what Watson and Crick discovered was the, and their immediate followers, was the machine code. Mm-hmm. And now what you're working on is the compiler language, the high-level language.
Yes.
That calls the machine code routines.
Yes. And unfortunately, what we're discovering is that high-level language is much more complicated than the machine code. It's
which again, you would expect, of course.
Yes.
But there are astonishing uniformities about it. And even as animals as distant as mammals and insects have similarities at the level of molecular embryology, which I would never have dreamed of when I was an undergraduate. I mean, one thought that the different phyla were just, you know, completely separate and
yes. Yeah, there's some quotes from Ernst Mayr, for instance, that talk about this, where he did not expect any homology between them. And so when we go digging and we discover, wow, there's an awful lot of it there, it's kind of surprising. But then on the other hand, you know, I think what it was is a difference in perspective, that Mayr was thinking of all these genes evolving, and what we're saying now is, no, what happened is the genes were being conserved by selection pressures, which is what you expect. Selection is going to be a conservative process, and it's going to retain the major structural motifs of a gene, and all the action, all the interesting changes are going on in the regulation of that particular gene.
Right.
Yeah.
When we speak as Darwinians and we're looking for what actually changes from generation to generation in evolution, then we are still, are we not, talking about what population geneticists always have, which is changes in gene frequencies. But when you talk about gene frequencies in gene pools, you mustn't forget that the important ones may be regulatory genes.
Yes.
Rather than just ordinary protein-making genes.
Or the regulatory elements of the genes. That's what's being changed.
Yes. Yeah. But it's still possible to say, as I would, what is the unit of selection in the sense of that for whom we use adaptive language? What is this adaptation, whatever it is, wing shape or skin color, whatever it is, for the benefit of? I can still say it's for the benefit of the gene that caused the difference between this set of individuals in the population and that set of individuals, those that have whatever it is, curvy wings or pointy wings.
Uh-huh.
There's still got to be a difference between them. And only genetic differences are preserved from generation to generation by natural selection.
Uh-huh.
So the metaphor of the selfish gene still works, but it doesn't mean gene in the simple sense.
Definitely not in the simple sense. It's not just single genes either. It's combinations of genes.
Yes.
A particular allele in one context is going to have a very different effect if it's in a different context. So what we see in populations is a lot of mixing and matching of these alleles, and it's combinations that are generating novelty.
There are two ways of handling that problem of combinations. One way is to say that whole combinations get selected as a group,
mm-hmm.
and sometimes maybe they do. But another way, which intrigues me more because it's sort of less obvious, is that from any one gene's point of view, all the other genes in the genome are part of its environment, almost part of its ecology.
Yes.
And the important parts of its ecology are those with whom it forms combinations, functional combinations. And so genes are being favored for their capacity to cooperate with other genes that they're likely to meet in bodies in the gene pool.
Uh-huh.
And so it's a sort of Adam Smithian version of the economy of the genome. But I think it's one that we shouldn't overlook anyway.
Correct. Yeah. No, I agree.
Okay.
And I've been writing this column for Seed for a while, and my focus has largely been on exactly this, that what we're looking at now is complex interactions between sets of genes. And that's the level you have to look at in order to understand development and to understand evolution of organisms.
Good. Thank you very much.
Yeah.